Very good morning, everybody. I'm in fact humbled and happy to be here. The award function which happened there was the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles. This is the site, the Shrine Auditorium, wherein I'm in front of a lot of youth and youngsters here. The first Indian to get the award there in Shrine Auditorium was R.A. Raghuman, and second is Akshaya Trust. Out of 100 countries, 10,000 nominations, I did not nominate myself. 100 countries, 10,000 nomination, Akshaya was been in top 24, and by the Blue Ribbon panel, top 10, and now top 2 in the world. I finished my BSc Hotel Management. In the midst of June 2002, I got a very lucrative job in Taj Hotel, Bangalore. I was supposed to go to Switzerland on a week's bond, on a 4-year bond. My mom said, "You are very naughty, please come here. So when you go back to Swiss for 4 years, you will not be back." So when I came here on a week's holiday, I saw a very old man having his own human waste for hunger. I was literally shocked for a second. I have never experienced such a situation before in my life. I thought, what is happening in my city? What am I going to do? I just went to the nearby hotel, brought sumptuous idlis and gave it to him. Within seconds, he finished those idlis and gave me a look of gratitude. If he would have thanked me that day, I would have again gone back to my Taj Hotel. It was a silent revolution of self-realization. After coming back home, I thought, what is going to be the purpose of my life? I prepare a plate of fried rice for $10 and sell in my hotel, wherein people come and have food just for fun, not for hunger. What am I going to do? God gave me the clarity to quit my job in 2002, and with the little amount of savings which I had, I started feeding people on the road. I was very cautious and clear not to feed the mentally ill people. I was very cautious and clear not to feed the beggars. My ultimate mission and vision was to feed the old people and the mentally ill people alone. I started feeding, and slowly public started contributing for the cost. From 2003, we registered a trust called Akshaya Trust in Madurai. And you would have seen a lot of people on the roads having big, big, long haircuts, hairs. So I thought, what am I going to do for them? I called a barber. Many barbers said, no, I'm not going to come and do this because these people are stinking. Some did said, okay, I will come and help them to give the haircut. So what happened was, the strangers, you know, the mentally ill people are supposed to be strangers. So they were, the mentally ill people were running left side and the barbers were running the right side, and it was a running and chasing game. But what is going to be the solution for this? And 2003, 2004, in the midst, I went to a Malaya saloon and professionally trained myself. I can now cut 11 varieties of haircuts, and so far I have given not less than 3 to 4,000 haircuts to people on the roads. 2003, now we have Apple phones, Blueberry, Blackberry, iBerry, Icon, Sony Ericsson, so many phones. Nowadays we have everything, but those times only landlines and pagers. My friends from Switzerland called my father and said, "Dad, the Krishnan did not come, I don't know why. Here we are paid very well. He got frightened. He being a chef, I can toss a fried rice for 4 foot height, not even a granule will fall down." So Krishnan did not come. What happened? My dad got confused, and he went and shared to his friends and relatives. It's really a very true incident which happened. Two suggestions was being given to my father. One, take him to a psychiatrist. The second is take him to Chotanikare, which is there in Kerala down south. Somebody would have done black magic to him. Do pujas, his mental illness will get cured. So my father was hesitant to talk to me. And after that, he slowly said that, "No problem, guy, you'll become all right. You have to be under basic medication and things like that." I told my mom and dad, "Okay, fine. I could not be here without your presence in this world. If you feel what I'm doing is not right, I don't want to do it. I will again go back to my Star Hotel and start feeding all the people over there. But before that, I want you to see what I am doing." Taking that into consideration, my mom and dad came along with me in the midst of 2003 to see all these people. And I told my mom, my mother and father, you should not sit inside the AC car and see what's happening. I want you to get down and give food to those people. So in 2003-04, my mom gave food to those people, put those people on the road. Lot of old people and mentally ill people on the road touched the foot of my mom and said, now we are able to eat 3 meals a day is only because of your son. I was being thrown out by the family, by my own son. My daughter threw me out, my daughter-in-law threw me out. And my mother was totally shocked. And after coming home, my mom said, my dear son, you feed all these people. I will feed you till I'm alive. So that was the inspiration, energy which my mother gave me. And I started this organization when I was 19 years old. And again, slowly witnessed that a lot of people on the roads die. I knocked out almost all the doors of the government concerns. Nothing cropped up, nothing turned up. People die on the road, and after 2 days, 3 days, the body has not been taken up. Dogs come and bite the human body which is there on the road. So I thought, what is going to be the solution? And from 2004 till now, I would have so far cremated 480 destitute bodies on the road. There was a huge problem in my community, because I hail from Brahmin community. Huge problem from my community, saying that you are grandson of Sri Great Krishnayar, you are the grandson of Sri Great Venkatramayar, you are not supposed to do this. I asked them, why? You are a Brahmin, you are not supposed to touch them, you are not supposed to hug them, you are not supposed to give them a haircut, you are not supposed to cremate. You are doing all type of activities which is not supposed to have your community to do. I said, what is bothering you? The sacred thread which you are wearing is bothering us. I said, if a small thread is going to bother me doing this activity, I don't want it. So in 2004-05, midst of 2004-05, I removed my sacred thread and I gave it to them. I am not a Brahmin. I don't have a caste, creed or color. I am just a human being. The regular routine of Akshaya for the last, it's going to be 1 decade now. We in the sense, we have now a team, volunteer base. Now I'm here in front of you is because we have trained and groomed almost about 6 volunteers. The mentally ill people on the road are being trained and groomed, and now they are active volunteers of Akshaya in Madurai. Now I'm here in front of you talking to you, but the mentally ill people are being cured and taking care of Akshaya in my absence wonderfully. Today morning I got a phone call from my chef saying that the idli has come out very well in your absence, sir. So the spirit behind is that those people have the dignity and hand to hold. We are feeding almost about 450 people 3 meals a day. Get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, cook the food, take it to the Maruti Omni van, go distribute, come back. Go to the market, buy vegetables, again come back to the kitchen, cook the lunch, go give it back, again come back, prepare the dinner. From 4 to 11, we are with the people, giving them haircut, clean shave, water to drink, clothes to wear. In 2006-07, I witnessed lot of mentally ill women are getting sexually harassed by the society, and they start giving birth to kids on the road. So far we have given legal adoption to not less than 43 kids. Last week we gave a legal adoption to a kid on the road. On 2007 I witnessed what is going to be the mission of Akshaya. Just going and feeding them, giving water, talking to them, we need to rehabilitate them. So 2008 we had an opportunity, Reliance Industries, Rajdeep Sardesai, Sri Mukesh Ambani, Nita Mukesh Ambani recognized Akshaya to be the best in India, and they gave us an award, a cash award of 5 lakhs of rupees. With that, with the help of Infosys Foundation and TVS group of companies, and with the land which grandfather gave me, I just sold it out and purchased almost about 3 acres of land in outskirts of the city. Now we have in an idea of having 8 blocks. Each block is about 3,000 square feet and 30 lakhs of rupees. The first block was being donated by LIC group of companies, LIC Golden Jubilee Foundation. Second block by TVS group of companies. Third block by Malini Chandrasekhar, Sunil Talwar, Qatar. Fourth by Manish Sharma, Singapore. Fifth, Rotary Club of Emery Hills, Atlanta, and only God knows who's going to be the donors for three more blocks. Once when the three blocks are done with all infrastructure, God willing, in other maximum 1.5 years, 250 kilometers radius of Madurai city, there will not be any mentally ill destitutes or old people or women left uncared in the roadside of the city. I am 29 now. When I am 30, July 31st next year, all the people will be housed. And that is my ultimate mission and vision. How did CNN come to know about Akshaya? It's all because of three reasons. One, organization run by the youth. And second one is, the excellent quality of food has been served to the destitutes who cannot claim for. And the third one is proper maintenance of accounts. From April, we had lot of responses from USA, because when it was on air from April of this financial year. We have registered ourselves in Akshaya USA. We have 501c3 status. We have ATG in India. We have 501c3 status, wherein people wanted to contribute, take up tax. And the best part of thing is that there are a lot of youngsters, after seeing Akshaya, quit smoking. They have quit boozing. And now our major supporters are youth, the students. We have put that in the website also. And what all I request you here is that, not Akshaya, it is not necessary that you have to help for Akshaya. Whomever you see on the road, spend time with the people who need your support. Go to a hospital, go to any ashram, spend time with them. Just see the joy of giving, that is ultimate. Whatever you have it for you is not yours. Whatever you give it for others, it is yours. I am enjoying my life for the last 10 years, from 19 to 29. So I want you also to enjoy your life. And all the speakers who are here in midst of me are all page one celebrities and not page three celebrities, because they have really translated their vision and mission into action. They have contributed immensely to the development of the country, and I am particularly delighted to be here. And I also wanted to thank MICA, Noor, and the management for giving me an opportunity. And once again, I wanted to personally thank, on behalf of 450 souls, to all the students and youngsters for working very hard to make this event happen. And it's definitely a very great success for you guys to get the license from California to make this TED happen. And the hospitality you have given to me, the way you are treating the guests is something awesome. And I wish you all success and all glory in life. I think you all would have had the handouts about Akshaya. Everybody has got brochures about Akshaya. So please visit our website and spread the word. And once again, I thank you all for giving me a golden opportunity. Jai Hind.